the favorite thing that I want to talk about. Hey, we're in Toronto. Let's talk about the Raptors. Cynthia, what do you think about the Raptors past season or just anything about the Raptors right now?
In my opinion, they could have done a lot better, especially in playoffs, but they just didn't. Like, the whole team wasn't working out during playoffs. They didn't play as a unit. So
you thought they could do? You thought they could go further, or you thought they didn't perform as well where they were at the end of the playoffs?
Just partially because of the coaches, because I guess their coaching system's not really working out now. So it's just the fact that since they want to have like a cultural change, like they may as well just switch up the whole coaching scheme with the team right now. So they're better prepared for the new season.
We have yet to see that, if there is a coaching change, because that's, like
that. That's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
That's exactly
week.
What I said too.
If there is going to be a culture change, because we haven't seen one yet, but there have been news about, well, it's made officially that DeMar Carroll will be heading to Brooklyn Nets for Justin Hamilton and a few picks. We're giving a first round and second round picks to Brooklyn.
Thank
for
you.
Yeah.
Justin Hamilton.
Thank you. Bye.
That's a good move just to ease off the money payroll, because that $60 million contract wasn't really working out with what he was doing on the Raptors. But I can't blame him just because, I mean, it's unfortunate that he went through injuries and we couldn't see the full player of DeMar Carroll.
He did mention too that upon the signing of that contract with the Raptors, he thought that they were going to play a different style, which was more ball movement and more passing like he was accustomed to with Atlanta. This is where he flourished when he played for Atlanta because Budenholzer had a really, unselfish kind of a system in his, where it was Horford running plays, Paul Millsap, a Korver running around, and him being a 3-and-D kind of player. He thought he was going to be in that kind of system where he flourished, and he didn't know that it was going to be the same kind of, I read an article about him saying, it was kind of a little bit of a bash to the system that when the Raptors were playing, the ISO ball, and he just wasn't used to that because, I'm not saying it's an excuse for him because he's a professional basketball.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying that,
his exact quote was like, this year I felt like a lot of guys didn't trust each other and a lot of guys, they didn't feel like other guys could produce or be given the opportunity. So there's a lot of lack of trust on the Raptors. So, I mean, it is kind of, people might take it as disrespect to the Raptors team, but that was what the Raptors were.
Yeah.
Dwayne Casey's system with DeMar DeRozan and Kyle Lowry were mainly ISO ball players. And he was just criticizing, constructive criticism towards the Toronto Raptors that they could have done a lot better in the playoffs with PJ Tucker, Serge Ibaka, Patrick Patterson, and everyone in the squad without having the ISO ball, like mainly go through ISO ball.
In paper, they looked like they were a team that was designed to beat the Cavs. Like, I wasn't expecting that on the playoffs too, right? So what they have right now, a culture change starts with a little bit of the role players that they have. So keeping their core, but really, if they're not going to do anything with their coaching staff, like what kind of change really, how big of a change really is it going to be if they don't make any changes in their coaching staff?
Yeah.
No matter how much Casey tries to change who he is, he's a defensive coach. He's going to do what he does best. Why would you try to change someone who was really good at what he did, which was, setting up defensive schemes for the Mavs that won a championship.
Yeah.
And they've set him, he made them play defensively. For the past few years, like, Raptors were a joke defensively when they had like Bargnani and like Calderon, and they were really bad defensively until like Casey came in and kind of fixed them up to be good defensively, right? And they've covered DeRozan really well. Like, he's not a great defender if you really watch him.
Yeah. Right?
And you mentioned also that when we talk about changing culture, you said changing coach, and then you threw out a name, you threw David Blatt out in the mix. What's the difference between David Blatt's and Coach Casey?
Oh, big differences.
A big difference in terms of how he runs the team. Like, if you think about this, he went to the finals on his first year with the Cavs. And he had to coach someone, the best player in the game. And he had to coach a team that he has to, and he basically came from Europe. So he's not like a coach that was, that was already in the NBA, kind of accustomed to how the NBA runs.
Yeah.
Or he was able to take a team that, everyone expected them to make it, but it's not as easy as you think. Like, the Lakers, when they had, a crazy number of players that were, like, Hall of Famers, like Peyton, Karl Malone, Shaq, Kobe, they had all, like, you know, all the pieces together, and they didn't really go that far. So I'm saying David Blatt is capable of, you know, whatever you give him in terms of players, he's able to make something out of it. And I think, you know, he can do something with the Raptors just because of how unselfish he runs the team.
So since this trade has been made official, DeMar Carroll to Brooklyn Nets, what do you guys think about the proposed trade? It's still a proposed trade because, you know, nothing really, there's a sign and trade you know, discussion going on. So what do you think about Corey Joseph heading to Indiana and CJ Miles coming to the Toronto Raptors?
I thought that was official, so I was just waiting for it to...
Not official yet.
Yeah. But still, I thought it's going to happen because I think they still need a three now because they lost
PJ.
DeMar Carroll and PJ Tucker.
Yeah.
But I think CJ Miles is more of a role player, a bench, coming off the bench spark kind of player, so they still need to have to sign a solidified wing player. So I think it's good to have, right? Because I think they have two guards that are, you know, coming in, Van Fleet and DeLon Wright, I like him. He's a capable defender, and I think he can run the second unit with
him. He's definitely going to be a good backup point guard. And I think that is what Masai is trying to do as well, as in, you know, keep the core, but also move in with the younger guys because, you know, if we don't have the younger guys,
it's about time.
The Raptors, there's not going to be a team now and into the future when DeMar or Kyle Lowry leaves. Mm-hmm. So at least we got that, you know, backup with Van Vliet, Fred, and DeLon Wright.
Fred.
And I mean, like, if I was telling this to a friend of mine, shout out to Ian, we were having this conversation. If DeRozan is willing to jump from a star player to a superstar, he has to be a two-way player. Like, two-way players, like, Kawhi, Durant, LeBron when he was at his prime, Paul George, they're able to play at both ends of the floor. If he can, he's long enough, he's tall enough to play a three guard position. If he can move to the three slot to that three and play his game, he can back up. You know, you can move Norman Powell to the two.
Yeah.
And you can have a solid two guard that, because Norman Powell plays at both ends of the floor. Yeah. But it's just a matter of if DeRozan willing to do that. That's my thing.
Yeah. Right?
Because if they can't find a solid wing player, I'd rather see him put that effort to go from star to superstar by playing at both ends of the floor and move Norman Powell to the two, right? And if you get CJ Miles, you got a lot of firepower coming off the bench. You don't need Norman Powell coming off the bench.
All right. Since we don't have a lot of time, let's predict. Okay, the Raptors this season. What do you think will happen with the Raptors this season?
Probably first round, but not second round.
Wow. Drop off. And Mark, what do you think?
It all depends to me of whether they sign a capable defender, because right now they don't have really. They lost PJ Tucker.
They lost defensive
players. Like Patrick Patterson was a great defender, right? So three defenders that they lost. That all depends if they replace it with someone. I know Ibaka was a great sign. But I think that since, you know, the East got a little bit weaker, if they go through Washington or Boston, they have a chance to go second round.
So second round, I'm taking it.
That's it.
And then yours.
I know I have to wait, but, like, yeah, I'd say second round too. This is what they're looking at, so.
I'll say first round.